So let's see how, what is function, okay? So function is like a machine, like a coffee machine or orange juice machine, okay? We can input yeah. any value, and for that value, we will get another value. For example, this is the definition. A function from a set D to a set Y is a rule, okay, that assigns a unique or single element f of x belongs to y. F of x belongs to y. To each element, okay. f belongs to d. That means, that means if we put a in value here, okay? For example, we can take a value of x here. So this is our input. And this input is called domain, okay? And this is our function, and we can get for this domain x, we can get a output that is called f of x, and it is also called range. Okay, so let me tell you again. This is a function. It can be any interval or any equation. Okay, so we will take some value of x in this function. And then we will, then the output will be the result of this function, okay? Or this we will call range. And this value of x, we will call him domain. So this is like a machine. So we take some orange here, and this is our function, and we get some orange juice here, okay? So let's see real example. Let's see some real example here. So we have a function y is equal to on divided by x. So to find the domain, we have to think. We have to remind two things. Okay, number on is our domain cannot be. A unreal number, okay? It must be a real number. This domain must be a real number. For example, some number divided by
second real number. The real number means -1, -2, or
no, no, no.
Or
yes, right, right. Yes, right. So domain must be a real number. So if we take like something like this, like c divided by 0, so it is not a real number, okay? And if we get root over minus something, this is also not a real number. Any number divided by 0, this is not a real number. And root over minus any number, okay? For example, c, okay? So root over minus c is not a real number. So yes. For domain, for the value of domain, we can take any real number, okay? Only we will not take these two things, okay? Root over minus c or c divided by 0.
And 0 ke domain hote pare na 0 0 to real number na
yes 0 can be also 0 divided by 2 this means it will be 0 so 0 is also a real number okay so we can
0 is real number
or domain we
mane 0 to 0 0 to 0 0 থেকে পজিটিভও যেতে পারে নেগেটিভও হতে পারে মানে -1 -2 হতে পারে +1 +2 ওকে
from 0 to plus infinity
yeah. and minus infinity
everything is real number okay only okay. these two things c divided by 0 and root over minus c these two are not real number okay
yes
so we have to think this way like we cannot take these two numbers right So let's put a value yes. here. Let's for example this x. So if we take take a value x equal to 0, then this becomes on divided by 0. This is not a real number.
Yes.
So our domain will exclude.
How can we how can it be 1 divided by 0? It will be 1 multiplied by 0.
Here is the function, right?
Oh, okay. I have got. I have got okay, actually. মানে ওই মাঝখানে দাগটা দেখি নাই আমি বলছি
এটা গুণ সো অন ডিভাইডেড বাই 0 মিস ইট ইজ নট নট ইকুয়াল টু আর ওকে লেট মি শো ইউ
ইয়েস
লেট মি শো ইউ দা এক্সাম্পল So, for example, I divide on divided by zero. Okay, so cannot be divided by zero. You can see, and if I take root over minus five, this is error, right? So these two things will make these two things doesn't belong to real number. So that's why our domain will be. Every real number except this zero, okay. And for this first bracket, it means it is a open interval. That means we don't take this value zero, okay. We can take any value up to minus infinity. From
এটা কিসের জন্য open interval?
Okay, you can see the sign here. This is a first bracket. So and this is a third bracket. So first bracket is open interval and third bracket is closed interval. And this is open interval because we cannot take this value zero, okay, as a domain. We cannot take this value zero as a domain. That's why it is. Yes. Okay. Let me draw the real line. This is zero, and this is -1, -2. Okay. So we don't take this value zero. And our interval will be from 0 to minus infinity. You remember this? We already learned it in our foundation mathematics class. So this means an open interval. We do not take this value 0, okay? Because if the value of x is 0, then this will be on divided by 0. It doesn't belong to a real number, okay? This is not a real number. On divided by zero. So Rajiv,
I'm just wanted divided by zero. Could it divide for a jana? Into on a kit to the zero chulase, but zero chulase divide cooler to shake it theater.
In that case, if this is on divided by zero, then we will use limits. Okay, then we will use limits like this way. Limit x tends to x naught, okay, x zero f of x is equal to zero, okay, something like this way.
Yes,
we don't take the this zero, we take this like x is very near to zero, okay, but x is not zero. That is called limits.
Okay.
So we have four people here. Jaman Farha is also here. So for example, let's see number four. Here we have y is equal to √4 - x. So as I already told you that this domain cannot be c divided by zero and √(-c). So let's take a value of x is equal to 4. Okay, something like something bigger than 4, that will be 6 or 7. Okay, let's take 7. So this will be √(4 - 7). √(4 - 7) is √(-3). So we cannot take minus inside of root, right? Because it makes an error. √(-3). This is error, right? So that's why. Our value will be, so that's why our domain will be from 4 to minus infinity, okay? Because if we take any value greater than 4, then it will be √(-c), okay? This will be like this way. That's why we have to exclude every number that is bigger than 4.
We
must take something smaller than 4. You can see the interval here. This is 4. We can also take 4, right? because this is a closed interval. You can see the sign. This is third bracket. Third bracket means we can take this value 4. Okay. From 4 to minus infinity, we can take any number. For example, we can take minus 2. If the value of x is equal to minus 2, then we get root over 4 minus 2 is equal to root over 2. Okay, this is also a real number. But if we take something bigger than 4, for example, root over minus 10, so it will be root over minus 6. So we cannot take minus inside of root, right? Root over minus c is not a real number, okay?
Achha, two jodi amra root kori tahole to point ashbe maybe. Ota ki real number hoy?
Yes, any number that is real number, okay? So only root over minus c and c divided by 0, these two things are not real number, and everything else is real number, okay?
Okay.
Here c means a constant, okay? Any value like 2.7, it can be on by root 2, anything, okay? C is any real number. So let's put 4 here. 4 minus 4 is equal to root over minus 0, right? So root over 0 is equal to 0. We also get a real number, right? This 0 is also real.
Yes.
So that's why our domain will be from 4 to minus infinity. You can see here. And we have to input some minus. We have to input this number here. Okay, we have to input this domain in our function, and then we will get some value of range. For example, if we input 4 here, let's start from the beginning. Like we can input 4 here. So 4 minus 4 is equal to root over 0. Okay, is equal to 0. So our value of range starts from 0. And now let's take some a smaller value than 4. It can be 2.
এখানে যে minus infinity দাও আছে এটা কি 10 থাকবে অল টাইম এরকম এটা রেজাল
বুঝিনি ভাই
এই 4 এর এখানে যে বাম সাইডে যে minus infinity দাও আছে
হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ ওটা কি 10 থাকে নাকি ওটা কারণ আমরা ওখানে minus infinity
so we have to find this domain and range. Only this function will be given. Only this function will be given, and this domain and range we have to calculate this. Okay.
Okay.
So let me put here minus 2, for example, because we can take any value smaller than 4, right? So let's put minus 2 here. So this will be minus 2 minus multiply minus 2 is equal to plus 2, right? Root over 4 plus 2. That is root over 6. So root over 6 is also a real number, and the value of root over 6 is 2.44, right? So here the range will be 2.44, okay? And 2.44 includes into this interval, right? You can see 0 to plus infinity. So 2.2 is inside of this interval, okay? This way we can find domain and range of any function. You only have to think these two things, okay? Nothing else.
আচ্ছা ভাই আমার কি একটু একটু বুঝাই দাও এখানে যে ডোমেইনটা মাইনাস ইনফিনিটি হলো ওই যে পুরো ওটা যেটা
বললাম okay I will give more example okay? Let's go forward and I will give more example. So you can see here a function.
Yes.
So we have y equal to x plus 2. This is our function, right? We can say it f of x. And we are taking some value like x equal to minus 2, x equal to plus 1, okay, x equal to 0. And okay, this is not a real example for. Let's see another example, okay? Okay, let's go to our class notes, and we will discuss from here. Okay. So for function, we have domain, we have a rule. This power is called rule. Okay, this power, like y is equal to x squared. Y is equal to x squared. This is our function, and this y is equal to range. Okay. And this value of x is a domain. This value of x is a domain. You remember? I already told you.
Yes, yes, yes.
Function is like a machine. You input orange here, and for output we can get orange juice, right?
Yes.
So for example, x is our orange, and we get y as a orange juice. So y is equal to x squared. This is our function. So we take some value of x and we get some value of y.
Okay.
So our teacher told us that y is equal to x squared and g is equal to t squared. Are these two functions same or not, right? So you can see if we take any value, like we can take any value here. And we just used t in case of x, and we just used g in case of y. So these two functions are same. Okay, there is no change. And here,
hey, if there is a problem, Arif, you can mute.
You can see here, you can find the domain of this function. This function is y is equal to x squared, right? So we can take. For this function, we can take any value, right? Any value can be go into this function, because if you take 5, 6, or minus 5, or 0, if we
root over 5.
If we take any value inside of this x, we get a value of y. That's why our domain will be x. Our domain will belongs to R. Okay. We can take any real number. So let's go to the next example. Here our function is a is equal to pi r square. So here is our circle. This is a function of circle. Okay, the area of circle. This is the area of circle. So here our r is like x, okay? R is like x, and this pi is like a constant. This pi is a c, or constant value. Do you know the value? Value of pi is 3.1416. Yeah.
4.16.
So here r will be x, and this pi will be c, or a constant value. So every time you imagine, every time this radius, this r will be positive, right? Because if r is negative, then you cannot draw a circle. R must be a positive, because this is a distance. Distance is always positive, okay?
Yes.
So our domain will be from 0 to plus infinity, okay? That's why here is our interval, the domain. The interval of domain is 0 to plus infinity. So let's go to the next example. We have y is equal to 1 by x. So this is our function. And we can take any value except 0, right? Because if 1 by 0, this is equal to, this doesn't belong to R, right?
Yes.
So here our domain will be x. Such that x is not equal to 0, okay? Every real number x, and x cannot be 0. This is our domain. So, Farha Jaman, then Emporio Rashid. Do you understand?
Okay, yes, I have got.
Okay, thank you.
তারা কি হলো কথা হয় না কেন
let's go to the next example. Y is equal to on minus x squared divided by on minus x. So here, if the value of x is equal if the value of x is equal 1, then this will be 0, right? On minus on is equal to 0.
Yes.
So we cannot take on in here, okay? So in this case, if we need to find, so here our domain will be x cannot be is equal to on, right?
Yes.
Okay. So how do you solve this? For example, we need to find some. Okay, so our teacher questioned us that if these and these two functions are same or not, okay? So these two functions are not the same because their domain is different. You can see here, we cannot take we cannot take one. But in this function, we can take any real number. See here, x belongs to us. That means we can take any real number here. That's why as their domain is different, so these two functions are not same. Okay?
Yes, yes.
If the domain and rule, if the both are same, then both functions are same. If domain and rule are same, then both functions are the same. Like for example, in our previous example, we had y is equal to x square and z is equal to t square, right? So here, yes. This is our rule. So this rule is same for this function and this function. Rules are same, and also domains are same. Like we can take any real number here. It can x belongs to R, okay? X belongs to R. So let's move forward. So let's draw some graph of y is equal to x function. So we can compare it like y is equal to x plus b. We can compare it with y is equal to x plus b. So if we take 0 here, if we take the value of x equal to 0 and y is equal to, then y will be also 0. You take here x is equal to 0, then y will be also 0. So for yes. The value of x is equal to 0, we get a value of y is equal to 0. Then we have to put this coordinate pair in our graph. This will be somewhere around here, right? Somewhere this graph. This will be here. And let's take x is equal to 1. Then y will be also is equal to 1. So our coordinate pair is on, comma on. This will be, here is our on and here is on. So this will be somewhere around here. Not always the graph is necessary. If they ask to draw the graph, then you will draw. Okay. So if we connect these two on these two points, then we will get our graph. Okay. And here is our line y is equal to x. So here is another example. Y is equal to 5x minus 2. So again, we take some value of x, like so in this case, we do not, we can do it another way. Like our ma'am did it like this way, and I did it like this way. Okay. So you can follow any step. Our Laoshi just took some value of x and y. For example, he took the value of x is equal to 0. And the value of y will be minus 2. And if you take y is equal to 0, then the value of x will be 2 by 5. So if we input these two coordinate pair in our graph, we will also get the same line, okay? And I did it another way, like I compared this equation with with this equation. This is our general equation of a line. So here this is the value of A and this is the value of B. So this
the
is
the value of A and value of B. ওটা কি ধরে নিচ্ছি আমরা?
Yes, this is not, this is something given, okay? This is given here.
Okay.
So this is called A. The number with X. The number before X we call this A, okay? And this constant we call it B. And this B is equal to this B will be Y intercept. Like this is our Y axis and B the value of B is equal to -2. That means the point will be -1, -2 here, okay? Yes. So this -2 is our y intercept and this A. So for this A will be, so we can take any value of X. This A is not needed at the first step, okay? We can take a value like x is equal to 1. Then Y will be what? 5 multiply on 5 minus 2, that means 3. So for x is equal to 1, y will be 3. So this is our on and this is 1, 2, 3. This is our point. So we just connect this y intercept and this point. Then we will get our graph, okay?
Yes, yes.
So now let's see some more example. Here is the equation of a circle. X squared plus y squared is equal to 1. This is the equation of a circle. So this is the radius, okay? So we take the radius here, 1, okay?
Radius means
a point on the circle and a point here. So here on the axis, okay? So if we connect these two points, then we get the radius. Radius is the distance from a point on the circle point. And the axis of the circle, okay? So x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared is a function of a circle. Here r is equal to the radius, okay?
Yes.
So we have another equation. This is y is equal to x squared. And this is an equation of a parabola, okay? This is called a parabola.
Oh, parabola is over there.
This is like a half circle, right?
Yes.
This is like a half circle.
আচ্ছা এটা কিভাবে আঁকে মানে এই ভাবে দিশ দেয় কি শুধু
আচ্ছা let me show you for some example. If we take a value like x is equal to 1, so y will be on a square. On a square is equal to 1, right? So for x is equal to 1, y will be also 1. Let's take 2 here. So if x is equal to 2, y will be 4, right? This is our function. If x is equal to 2, y will be 4. So this is 2, 4. So let's put these two value here. Like 1 here and on here. So this is 1, 1. And 2, 4 will be 1, 2 here and 1, 2, 3, 4. Somewhere around here, right? And let's take 0, okay? Let's take x is equal to 0. So if x is equal to 0, 0 square will be 0. So that means our point is 0, 0. This will be here, right? Let's take minus 2. So for minus 2, x will be, for x is equal to minus 2, y will be what? Minus 2 squared is equal to 4, right? So let's go -1, -2 here. And -4 will be, 4 will be here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, somewhere around here.
এখানে তো -4 হচ্ছে না তাহলে আমরা ব্যাকে কেন হচ্ছে ওটা মাইনাস দিয়ে এখানে
আমরা নো ফর x is equal to -2 y will be 4 so -2, 4 point will be here firstly we go to x axis then we go to y axis for x axis -2 will be on the left side like -1, -2 and for the value of y it will be on the upper side 1, 2, 3, 4 okay so you can see if we connect these four points it will be something like this right a half circle or this is called a parabola Okay, so y is equal to x square is an equation of parabola. So let's move forward. A function will be given, okay? This function will be given. And they will tell us to find some value of domain or range, or they will tell us to draw the graph, okay?
Okay.
On the last line, we have to say that this is the equation of a parabola. And every time we will find a parabola for this equation. So let's move forward. So everyone, did you understand? So number three, we have f of x is equal to y is equal to the absolute value of x. So for absolute value of x, if x is greater than zero, that means if x is positive, if x is greater than or equal to zero, y will be also positive, okay? Y will be x. And if x is less than or equal to zero, then y will be minus x. Okay?
Okay.
So, here we will take some value here. Like if we take x is equal to minus one, so y will be plus one, right? Because you can see here x is equal to minus 1, then y will be plus 1. So minus 1, comma plus 1. The point will be somewhere around here, right?
Yeah.
And now let's take the value of x is equal to 0. So if the value of x is equal to 0, then y will be also 0, right? So the point will be here.
Yes.
So this is our line for y is equal to minus x. Okay?
এখানে যে x এর মান minus 1 নিলে y এর মান plus 1 হয় এটা কি হবে একটু বলতে পারবে y
ভাই আরেকবার বলবে তুমি প্লিজ আরেকবার বলবে
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ বলছিলাম যে x এর মান যদি minus হয় তাহলে ওখানে y এর মান plus 1 কি হবে এটা কি হবে
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে আসলে if we take x is equal to minus 1 then its absolute value will be always positive, okay? As we learned, modulus minus any constant, this will be a plus number, okay? Modulus is the absolute value. So for example, if I want to find the distance between these two points, this is called the absolute value, okay? Like we have a point here, and we want to find the distance from the origin, okay? The distance from the origin. So it will be here to here, right? So we know distance is always positive. So this is called the absolute value, okay? Absolute value means the distance. And distance is always positive. Okay. That's why modulus minus 1 is equal to plus 1. Okay? Absolute value will be always positive. But we can take negative numbers. We can take negative 1, negative 2, okay, anything. But every time, the value will be always positive.
Okay, got it.
So for now, let's take some value.
Yes.
So, okay, let me show you. We draw this graph, okay? So we can take any value, like x is equal to 1, then y will be minus. Oh, no. This is just this is just these two things, okay? This is just these two things. Do not mix this up. This and these are the same. You can see here, this and these two things are same, okay? Do not mix it up. Yeah, you can skip these parts. These parts are nothing, okay? Do not mix this. So maybe
এটা
পুরো বলে দেব ভাই এখানে কিছু না ভাই একই জিনিস আমি নিচে যে জিনিসটা এটা আমি উপরে লিখছি এখানে